away?
I'm not running anywhere. The coffee, please.
Whoa. It's been a rough morning in surgery. I didn't think I looked that bad.
Noah?
Yes, I do.
Do you have something to say?
Yes. As a matter of fact, I wanted to say I thought you did a wonderful job in surgery this morning.
Thank you.
But wait, there's more. I also wanted to invite you to lunch, but you took off before I could.
Thank you, but I brought something from home. Excuse me.
Claire, have any messages?
I'll check. I think there's one.
Oh, it's cheerful. Thanks.
Hello. I'd like to see Dr. Alan Quartermaine, please.
I'm sorry Dr. Quartermaine isn't here. Did you have an appointment?
No, actually my appointment's with Dr. Katz, but I just thought, what time do you expect Dr. Quartermaine?
He checked out for lunch about half an hour ago. Would you like to leave a message?
No, that's not necessary. I can check with him later. I'm doing Dr. Katz's office now. Thank you very much.
Nobody around here ordered those things.
This is the Quartermaine residence, isn't it?
Well, yeah.
Where do you want them?
But just get them as far away from me as possible. The damn things make me sneeze.
Uh-huh. Trying to get on Mother's good side, are you?
Don't be ridiculous.
Where should I put them?
I don't care any place.
Put them on the table, will you, please? Well, who do you suppose they're for?
How should I know? Don't look at me. I didn't order those things.
Don't mind him. He's allergic to all things bright and beautiful. Thank you. Now, who do you suppose sent those? Do you think Mama has a secret admirer?
Oh, you know, you're naughtier than she is.
No, don't say that. Do not underestimate my mother. I mean, she's a very attractive woman, and you said yourself you don't know what she's been up to these days.
Nonsense. At her age?
What do you mean, at any age?
Here's a card. Oh, no, it's not your mother who has a secret admirer. It's your soon-to-be ex-wife.
What?
Well, it is addressed to Monique.
Monique? Let me see that.
Yeah, it's French for Monica, I believe. She's not even back from Paris yet, and already she's Monique.
Monique or Monica, she's unbearable in any language.
Well, she'll return here more French than Napoleon. You know, come to think of it, they have a lot in common.
When is Madame Lafarge coming home? God bless you.
Well, if I can take your mother's muttering seriously, sometime this afternoon. You know, you'd find it a lot easier if you just went ahead and opened it.
Why are there always more bills than anything else?
I ask myself that same question every day.
Aha! I have lucked out junk mail! Look at that.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm so glad I caught you.
Can I get you something?
Oh, no, nothing. Thank you, Martha.
Okay.
Well, I just came by to tell you how happy I am. You are too, aren't you?
I haven't asked myself that question yet today, no.
Well, I mean, since we got everything all ironed out.
Did we now?
Yes. No more arguments. No more misunderstandings. You know, sometimes I have to pinch myself to believe everything's all right. It is, isn't it?
I wouldn't say that. Not at all.
I thought everything was settled between us the other day.
No, not really.
We talked about it. I explained everything to you. You even kissed me.
We've got to talk this whole thing out.
What whole thing out?
The humongous argument that we had over absolutely nothing.
I think the argument was over Scotty Baldwin.
Oh, he's not the problem.
Oh, he was pretty important the other day.
Keep your voice down, please. Then let me explain it to you. The whole thing, Scotty, the going out to the ballet with him on a date.
Okay,
and going up to upstate New York.
I understand you have a reason to be mad, and I'm sorry.
No, it's not important. None of it was important. I could deal with all of that. Except that something else was going on.
Nothing is going on between Scotty and I. You know that.
I'm talking about you and I.
You were ignoring me.
Maybe I was at the time. It's very possible that I did ignore you. Maybe I tried to ignore you, but it was all surface. It was all camouflage. Because you and I have never, ever discussed the very basic issues.
I don't know what you're talking about.
We've had problems all along, since way before Scotty ever got back.
You know what, Joe? I think you try to create problems for us.
It's not true and you know it.
I think you're creating a situation so you don't really have to get deeply involved.
You're wrong. Because I want a relationship to be built on a very solid foundation. And to do that, I think we have to discuss the very basic issues.
Fine. Let's talk about it.
If you're willing to talk, let's have dinner tonight.
I'd love to.
Someplace where no one will disturb us.
I'd like that.
Is the floating rib okay?
Sure. I'll meet you after work.
If you would.
Great. About 6 o'clock?
Yeah, I'll be fine. We'll have an early dinner and we'll talk all night if we have to.
Joe.
What?
Are you changing your mind?
My mind is so cluttered up right now, I don't even know it.
You do still want me, don't you?
Until I find out what's going on, I don't know what I want.
Problem at all. Well, I sure appreciate it on such short notice.
You can thank a cancellation for that. Oh, let me take your coat.
Thank you.
Sit down, please.
Okay.
So, what can I do for you?
I think you know why I came.
Well, you know, I really don't like guessing games so much, so why don't you just fill me in, huh?
I wanted to see you before the problem got any bigger.
You still haven't told me what the problem is.
Alan did come to see you. He told me so himself. Professionally, I mean.
Yeah, that's certainly true.
Well, so it's actually his problem that I just don't know how to deal with.
Well, why would you want to take on his problem?
Doctor, if Alan doesn't feel the same way about me that he used to, I'd like to know about it.
Was that what he's told you, that his feelings toward you have changed?
No. No, he hasn't actually told me that, but... Well, if he's unhappy, I'm not very good at this.
Oh, now, listen, look, we have plenty of time. Why don't you just relax?
Look, I just want to know what's wrong with Alan, that's all.
I see. You want to know what's wrong with Alan, and you really think that I'm going to tell you, huh?
Well, he talked to you. He told me so himself.
And what else did he tell you?
Nothing. That's just the problem. I don't know how to help him.
Miss Moore, Alan came to me professionally. Now, there is no way that I'm going to betray his confidence, not to you or to anybody else.
I was afraid you were going to say that.
Well, then I'm glad I didn't disappoint you. Well, is there anything else? Any particular problem you might be having that I can help you out with?
There's nothing wrong with me, Doctor, except worrying about Alan. If you could just... If I just knew how to help him.
Maybe you shouldn't try.
How can you say that? I live with him. I had his child. Now there's got to be something I can do for him.
Why don't you let him work out his own problem?
Just sit by and watch him be miserable? I can't do that.
I know this may sound very hard and very cruel to you, but in a lot of cases, letting someone work out his own problem is the best thing to do.
Yes, I'm sure that's probably true in a lot of cases, but... Don't you think we should be able to depend on those we love to help us?
Believe it or not, a lot of times that kind of help can be counterproductive.
Well, I've got to try. You see, I love Alan too much to just sit by and do nothing. So one way or another, I will find some way to help him.
Is it French?
Oh, thank you. I know that.
Well, what's it say?
It says, Les jours avec toi étiennent sans pareil.
Sounds awful.
Mais les nuits étiennent comme un rêve vivant.
Well, what the devil does that mean? My French is getting a bit rusty.
It isn't all that rusty. What it means is, I spent some incredible nights there with you. Roughly speaking, that is.
Oh, nights. Well, apparently your wandering wife did more in Paris than just look at the Eiffel Tower. Who signed it?
No signature.
Yeah? No, I don't wonder. Guy could be arrested for indecent speech or something.
I don't understand. She was supposed to be at a cardiology conference.
Well, affairs of the heart. Apparently she became involved in one.
Oh, please. She must have just given somebody some advice on an operation, triple bypass or something. That's just his way of showing gratitude with flowers.
Oh, gratitude, really. Alan, do you have any idea how much a basket full of those things cost?
Well, I wish I could stay and find out. And what she was up to, but I don't. I've got to get to the hospital. I have to go to an exercise class. Would you believe that? Hello. Another one.
Oh. Should I put it next to the first one?
What is all this?
More French words. We supposed to be translators? Here, brush up on your rusty French. I'll check with you later.
Miss Class, enough. Am I going to see you today?
I bought a salad. No, I cannot go today. I'm going to scrub.
Jesse, am I going to see you?
I certainly hope so.
Okay.
Bye-bye. Oh, gee, I wish my relief would get here. I hate being late for Richard's class.
You're really into it, aren't you, Jess?
Best thing that ever happened to me.
Yeah, everybody seemed to think that.
Well, I was kind of reluctant in the beginning, but now I hate to miss one, and I have a feeling he's going to be starting any minute.
Listen, why don't you go ahead, and I will take over until relief gets here. Come on.
Oh, Anne, thank you. I can't ask you to do that.
You didn't ask. I volunteered. I got half an hour before I have to scrub anyway. Go ahead.
You sure you wouldn't mind?
I don't mind a bit. Go on.
Well, it's just that I suddenly have a feeling that when I move, I may not fall apart.
Well, then you better get to class. Come on.
Are you sure?
I'm positive. Go, scoot. Come on.
Thank you.
What are you doing here, Anne?
What does it look like I'm doing here, Heather?
You haven't been demoted again, have you?
No, dear. You see, I'm helping out a friend, but you couldn't possibly understand that, could you?
Hi, Anne.
Hi.
Anne, what are you doing behind the desk?
I'm helping Jessie out. She went to class, and I'm filling until her release.
I'm on my way to the torture chamber myself.
Oh,
do you have any messages?
You. I think you do. Yep, one. There you go.
Two. These will wait until I'm bent out of shape again.
Come on, Jessie said those classes are the best things for getting you into shape.
She's right, and they're terrific, and I'm late, and I gotta go change. I'll see you later.
Bye-bye.
Hello.
Susan.
Did you have a nice lunch?
What are you doing here?
Is general hospital off limits to me?
No, don't be silly. I was just wondering what you were doing here, that's all.
Oh, well, as a matter of fact, I just had an appointment with Dr. Katz.
You what?
I had an appointment with Dr. Katz.
Why would you want to go and see Dr. Katz?
Because I thought maybe he could help.
With what?
Problem, of course.
How dare you do something like that without consulting me first?
Consulting you? It's pretty funny. You don't even have time to talk to me anymore.
You want to talk? We'll talk.
Alan.
Not here, not now, but we'll talk.
Okay, fine. When? Tonight at home? If you can manage to find your way, I'll make us a nice dinner. We can be alone. We can talk until dawn if we have to.
I don't want a romantic dinner. I just want to talk to you. Floating rib, 6 o'clock, okay?
You just don't want to be alone with me, do you?
Don't be so stupid.
Maybe that's exactly what I've been all this time.
You wear me down, Susan. I'll see you at the floating rib, 6 o'clock.
And Sam. Two. And again. Come on, you can. And again. Five. Two, Jesse, you're doing fabulous. Dr. Quartermaine with a lovely exercise outfit. And again. Up.
Sorry, I'm sorry to bother you.
How are you?
I just left Susan.
Yeah.
What did you say to her?
What do you think I said to her?
Well, she said to me that you discussed our problem.
No, that is what she wanted to discuss.
Well, what did you say to her?
Alan, I really can't bend and breathe and talk to you at the same time. Where are you?
All right, for God's sake, will you tell me what you said to her?
Alan! You know very well I never violate a patient.
Dr. Quartermaine, you didn't come dressed for class. I mean, what seems to be the problem? You were trying to have an exercise class, and you're disrupting again. Up, side, exhale.
Actually, I don't mind the disruption, you know what I mean? Here we go.
You can do 20 more of these. And again, let's hear it. Up, side, and yeah, you can do it.
Dr. Hardy?
Yes?
Your secretary wasn't at her desk.
Oh, Susan. No, she's out today. Please come in.
Oh, hope you don't mind my barging in like this.
Oh, quite the contrary. I welcome the interruption. I'm not doing too well with this financial report. Please, sir.
Thank you. I'll just stay for a minute. I was actually on my way out when I ran into Alan, and then I knew I had to come back here and talk to you.
Problems?
Just one. I'm really worried about Alan, Doctor.
Oh?
I'm afraid there's something seriously wrong with him.
In what way, Susan?
Well, that's just it. I don't know.
Well, have you expressed this concern with him?
Yeah, I have. I mentioned it to him, but every time I bring it up, he just brushes it off.
I see.
You know, I even went to see Dr. Katz because I knew Alan had gone to see him. I thought it might help.
And what did Dr. Katz say?
Nothing. I guess I didn't really expect to hear anything from him, but, well, knowing that Alan had seen him, I was hoping maybe he could help somehow.
Well, you know how a doctor respects a patient's confidence.
I know, but, Doctor, if there is something wrong with Alan, I want to know about it. And it would be just like Alan to hide some illness from me to keep from upsetting me.
Well, I doubt that he's doing that.
Well, I can't stand all this secrecy anymore. I mean, it's causing so much tension and so much pressure between us.
Susan, I think I can ease your mind on that score. Alan is not suffering from a physical illness.
Well, then what is it?
There's no way I can answer that.
Doctor, somebody has to.
Well, all I can do is assure you that he's in fine physical shape.
Well, I guess I should be grateful for that.
Look, why don't you speak to him directly? I'm sure when he realizes how concerned you are, he'll open up to you.
All right. Guess I'll have to give it another try.
If I were you, that's exactly what I would do.
You're right, Doctor. No sense wasting any more time.
In the meantime, try not to worry. Hmm?
Oh, I am so tired of worrying, Dr. Hardy. I've got to do something. And I will, thank you. Oh. Please don't tell Alan I was here, all right? Everything I do lately seems to irritate him.
Talking to me?
Noah, I just got off the desk. I have 5 minutes before I have to scrub for Dr. Cunningham's surgery, and I'm resting, and I really have nothing to say.
Anne, will you stop this?
I have nothing to say, Noah.
Okay, then I'll say something. All right? I'm sorry for what happened the other night in my apartment.
You mean what didn't happen in your apartment the other night?
Well, at least I'm on the right track. We do know what's bugging you then.
I'm not bugged. I just feel like a fool.
Don't. There's no need to. A little embarrassed, maybe. Look, I said it before, and I'll say it again, and I do care about you. I am your friend, and I do care about you.
Not enough to make love to me, though.
Enough not to. Just for the record, resisting was not easy.
I have to scrub.
Wait, think about something for me then, all right?
What?
There are different types of love. Mine for you is just as real as any other type of love. Always will be.
I always think about what you say, Noah. And that will always be too. By the way.
What?
Thanks for understanding.
Glad I caught you. I want to apologize for the other night. I should never have barged in on you like that.
Dr. Arthur Bradshaw, please call the lobby desk.
No rest for the weary. Dr. Would you hang in for a minute? I'll just see what that is.
Yeah, sure.
Something for me? Take this, Jess.
Oh, thank you.
Hello? Dorothy? I told you not to call me here. Now, isn't it enough that you badger me at home and upset Eleanor? I mean, why do you have to call me at the hospital? All right, hold on. I'll see if I can get another phone. Can I take this over there?
Oh, sure. Of course, Ken.
Hold on.
Am I glad you're back? Look.
What are you doing, planning a reception?
I'm planning to have a severe asthmatic attack. You know, flowers have been arriving for Monica every hour on the hour, By 4 o'clock, we could have a funeral.
What, all from the same person?
Well, how do I know? Good Lord, I hope so. I mean, she's only been gone 4 days. How many people could she get to meet in that time?
Knowing Monica, the entire French Foreign Legion. But that's another story. What do the cards say?
Well, I don't know. They're all in French, although I think one refers to her as a little cabbage.
A little cabbage? Does it possibly say ma petite choux? That doesn't mean a little cabbage. It means my little darling, my little sweetie pie.
Oh, look, I know that, my boy. Look, I was using those terms of endearment long before you were born. And I remember this sweet little thing. I mean, she lived down an alley on the left bank. Darling, darling, darling. God, I haven't thought of her in years.
Well, you better stop thinking about her. Your blood pressure's going to shoot straight up again.
Well, never mind my blood pressure. Doesn't it disturb you that some Frenchman is turning this place into a hothouse?
No, why should it disturb me? I'm quite impressed, actually.
Impressed by an avalanche of flowers for your wife?
Oh, not by the flowers, by her incredible energy.
Well, perhaps this trip she had one of those injections. Well, you know, they do have this fabulous new drug in Paris. I understand it's supposed to work wonders. Matter of fact, I've been thinking of looking into it myself.
Bonjour, mes amis.
Well, here you go, Jess.
Oh, thanks very much, Gail. Well, you know, it's kind of wonderful. Every time I have a class with Richard, I feel like I go out and lick the world and look good doing it.
Yeah, I know how you feel. It really does do something for you, doesn't it?
Yeah, I wish we had a class every day.
Well, you know what we should do, Jess? We should exercise on our own a bit every day.
I know. I try, but I'm not very good at it.
I know. You kind of have to build it into the day. You know, if I don't do it the first thing when I get up, then I never get it done. But I've even got Lee doing some stretches with me early in the morning.
I think that's great.
Yeah.
Speaking of Lee, I haven't seen him in a long time. How is he?
I don't know. I haven't seen him myself in a long time.
Huh?
Oh, well, I mean, there's nothing wrong, just that he's been away. He has a lot of clients out of town. You know how that is. Comes and goes.
Well, you can't complain about business being good.
No, no, I tell myself the same thing. It's just that I miss him. I guess the only cure for that is work, which I will get back to right now. Listen, I'll be in Dan's office for the next few minutes, okay?
Okay, fine.
Thanks.
Explain this over and over again. You've got to be reasonable.
Hello, Jessie.
Hi, Heather. You have something for me?
Yeah, the morning's missions. I would have brought them up earlier, but I went out to lunch.
No problem.
Oh, I'm glad. I don't like to make any mistakes around here. See you later.
Okay.
Well, hello, Heather. You're just the person I'm looking for.
Scotty, I'm awfully busy right now.
So just take a minute.
Yeah, but I really have to go.
No, but you'll want to see this.
What is it?
Just go ahead, open it, see.
General Hospital will continue in a moment.